President of Interpol, Mrs. Maria Balestrazi, Secretary General of Interpol, Mr. Ronald Noble, distinguished colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Let me start by thanking His Serene Highness Prince Albert and our hosts for your warm hospitality and the excellent arrangements at this year's Interpol General Assembly. I would also like to thank Interpol for this opportunity to speak at the special Interpol Global Complex for Innovation Recognition Ceremony. With globalization and technology, the world has become more interconnected and interdependent. Mobile communications connect us anywhere, anytime. We can get to the other side of the world with one hop on a jetliner or glide between cities on high-speed trains. And those great canals, Panama and Suez, have been enlarged to take bigger ships and even more cargo. We see great transnational flows of people, trade, capital, and ideas, which have benefited our peoples and made their lives better. Companies operate on a multinational basis. However, criminals have also taken advantage of this interconnectedness to carry out more transnational crime and cybercrime. These developments make it even more important for governments to work together, not just among ourselves, but also with the private sector in order to effectively combat crime. I join in congratulating Interpol as it celebrates 100 years of international police cooperation this year. Building on the strong foundation of cooperation, the Interpol General Assembly unanimously endorsed in 2010 the proposal to set up the Interpol Global Complex for Innovation, or the IGCI, in Singapore. We, in Singapore, are honoured by the trust that Interpol members have placed in us. The IGCI will draw upon the knowledge and experience built up by Interpol at its headquarters in Lyon. The IGCI will complement and help to spread the good work done at the mother campus in Lyon to support policing efforts to tackle new and emerging crimes, not just in the Asia-Pacific region, but around the world. By working with the private sector, the IGCI can also develop innovative solutions to boost our policing capabilities. Through the Digital Crime Center, the IGCI will allow law enforcement agencies to share information, understand emerging trends, and forge strong partnerships to combat cybercrime at the global scale. It will provide tools and techniques for member countries to counter the latest trends and set global standards and protocols in investigation and forensics. Besides bringing together public agencies and officers, the Digital Crime Center will also work with private sector partners and academia to strengthen our overall efforts against cybercrime. Singapore is honoured to host the IGCI. Located in a prime location, the IGCI building was handed over to Interpol on the 30th of September this year. I would like to thank Interpol and all member countries for your continued support and commitment to make the IGCI vision come to fruition. The opening ceremony of the IGCI will be held on the 13th of April 2015, next year. This will mark the commencement of full operations in the IGCI. Let me take this opportunity to invite our fellow ministers to join us in Singapore to celebrate this milestone as we continue to work together to turn back crime and keep all our countries safe and secure. While you are in Singapore, we can also share experiences and renew friendships with colleagues at the Interpol World Dialogue and the Asian Regional Conference, which will be held in Singapore during the same period. I look forward to the ministerial meeting tomorrow, and I hope to welcome all of you in Singapore next April. Thank you very much.